Hey, are you a mom who has a full-time job, or are you a mom who stay at home with a little one and you still want to build a business on the side, or you want to be successful in your business so that you could actually walk away from the job? Between the cleaning, the cooking, the taking care of the kids and the husband, the household, everything, or that 8-hour shift that you finish, you feel as you never have enough time to dedicate to your business. You feel as you're running the marathon all the time. Hey, my name is Candace from createfreedomwithcandace.com. In this video, I'm actually gonna share with you how did I, as a single mom, conquer all of this scheduling overload with taking care of my kids 2 years ago when I first bring my business online, while my son technically was on my lap and taking care of the other daughter who's going to school, but also bring in the income. So let's get started. We all have 24 hours. It's not about managing your time because, you know, Bill Gates, Oprah, they all have 24 hours. They don't manage their time. What they do is they manage their activity. So I want you to keep that in mind. With that being said, my tips number one is, instead of making a to-do list, you will have to make a not-to-do list. As a mom, when we're building our business, yes, you have your to-do list of what you need to accomplish. However, a lot of time you are not able to complete your to-do list of the day is because you are doing something that you're not supposed to, such as you walk past your son's bedroom and his bedroom is messy and you attempt to go and clean up his bedroom, or such as you tell him to come to clean up his bedroom and next thing you know you are there to helping him, so you waste time right there, right? Or you walk past the kitchen, you just want to put this plate away so that, you know, the counter look clean. The next thing you know, you're cleaning up the whole kitchen. So little things like that actually get people to stop doing what they're supposed to do. So my tips number one is a not to-do list. What are you not supposed to be doing when you're focusing on a project? You will put down not to clean up the kids' room, not to pick up the plates, not to do the laundry today, so that you intentionally know that these are the things that I'm not supposed to do so that I could actually focus on what I need to do. Got it? Number two, plan ahead. Utilize your night time and weekend time. Now, this is very important, at least for me. As a single mom, I have my kids almost 7 days a week. And night time, when they come home from school, that's the time that they have with me because they are away from school all the time. So what I do is during those time between 4 to 9 o'clock, those time, I am not actively building my business at all. In fact, anything at all. But when do I build my business? I build my business either I get up an hour early in the morning so that I could actually do something that require me to have some quiet time, such as making video, or I do it after they go to sleep. Because they're kids, they go to sleep early than I am. Yes, I do go to sleep late. Some of you said, you know what, I have a full-time job. I can't go to sleep much later than I already am. You want to achieve the dream that you want, you must sacrifice something. Can you stay up an hour or two later than the kids go to sleep? So if your kids go to sleep at 9 o'clock, which that's my kids' bedtime, I work from 9 to 11, 12 o'clock. Now, I'm not asking you to do what I do, but at least if you could really focus on that 1 hour on a project, that is very, very good. An hour you could accomplish a lot. So really plan ahead. Also on weekend, what do you do on weekend? See, this is where a lot of people get sidetracked because weekend, we're not supposed to be working. A lot of people get sidetracked on weekend. If the weekend, such as, let me give you an example. In the morning, when I get up on the weekend, I get up early. The first 2 hours that my kids are not awake, those are the 2 hours that I will be working on something that creative, right, require me to be quiet. When they wake up, that's the time that I have. I will actually have a certain time for my kids, and then I will be working, right? On the weekend, I dedicate more work to plan ahead for my week, such as I'm doing video. On the weekend, I will record 2-3 videos for the next week ahead so that I could actually not needing to worry about recording video for the next few days. Got it? So make sure you plan ahead of exactly what you need to work on for the rest of the week. Tips number three, don't multitask. Yes, we are women tend to multitask and we are really good at it. But did you know that when you're multitasking, when you switch from one task to another one, you're actually wasting some time and energy? Let me give you an example. If I was making a video, whenever I finish one video and I'm gonna go to edit another video and then come back do another video, it actually requires more of my time and energy. So what I do is I will actually focusing on recording the video. I will record all my video and then I will sit down and edit it all of my video at once instead of recording video, edit video, recording video, edit video. That takes a lot of time. So don't multitask. Tips number four, find your sweet spot. What do I mean by that? Well, look at the workload that you have. Are there work that require you to be more creative? Are there work that require you to actually sit down and do something? And then there's some work that you could probably do as it go. You want to take a look at the work that you have. Let me give you this example. My creative work would be writing, creating image, or recording video. Those are my creative work. And I do my creative work the best in the morning, during the morning time, before 12 o'clock. Once the 12 o'clock hit, I'm kind of drained, I'm kind of tired. It's hard for me to sit down. So you kind of need to know what's your sweet spot, right? So for me, if I need to do creative work, I will do it in the morning, knock it all out. And then in the afternoon, when I am kind of drink. Now this is the time that I probably need to start building some relationship, liking some posts, engage with people, having conversation, connecting with people. Those kind of things does not require me to sit still. I could do it as I'm walking around, right? You need to find your sweet spot. When is the best time for you to do creative stuff? And when is the best time for you to do busy stuff? And then when my kids come home, when they come home, I will be able to do the cooking and everything. I will always able to focus on them. Tips number five, give your 100% to whatever task that you're working on. Now, this may sound easier than done. Here's an example. If your mom who has a full-time job and had a young baby at home, have grandma or somebody babysit for you, while you're at work, you keep texting to see how the baby's doing. And then when you get home, your phone keep ringing because you keep having email coming in. You keep tend to check the work email. So if you keep doing that, when you're at work, you're checking on the baby, you can't focusing on work. When you're at home, you're checking on the work email, you will never be able to focus on your baby. So you feel guilty from time to time. When you leave home to go to work, you feel guilty as you don't have time with your baby. And when you come home from work, you feel guilty that you didn't get work done. Here's a better way to do it. You put your baby in trust that you know that you could trust them. So let it be. If there's an emergency, they will contact you. So focus on your job 100% when you're at work. But when you are home with your kids, turn that phone up, turn that phone upside down, turn that email notification up so that you will focus on your baby. By doing that, when you go to work, you do not feel guilty for leaving your baby. And when you at home being with your baby, you don't feel guilty as you did not finish the work because you gave your 100% at work and at home with your baby. Now here's the one that is very important if you are a busy mompreneur and you feel as you don't have enough time to do anything. This is big for me and it helps me a lot. You must find a platform that allow you to do automation. There are different social media platforms that we are building our business on. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, blog, whatever that is. You need to find a platform that allow you to do automation so that while you're at work or while you're busy taking care of your kids, they still going. Now, one of the automation platform that I use is Twitter. I love Twitter. I love that it allows me to do automation. I load up all of my content on one Saturday morning, and then the content will keep going for the rest of the 6, 7, or even a year, and I don't need to create new content if I don't have to. And also have other tools that help me follow, unfollow, and message people so that while I'm at work or while I'm busy with my kids or while I'm doing other stuff, it's still going. While I'm asleep, I'm still generating leads, right? When I have time, my job is not there to post and like post anything. My job is following up the lead. Now, if you want to learn more on how to actually automate your Twitter account, if you have a Twitter account, instead Instagram, you can also automate part of your work on Instagram as well. I'm actually going to include a couple of training in the comment, in the description here, so that you could actually learn some automation so that you will make the platform to work for you, not against you. You don't want to be on the computer all the time. I use Twitter and Instagram, and I actually automate a lot of my work there. Like I said, I generate leads and sell on Twitter and Instagram quite a bit, and even when I'm sleeping. So there you have it. Those are the tips that could help you stay focused and actually achieve more in your busy life. Now, remember, it is not time that you need to manage. You cannot manage time. It is the activity that you need to learn how to manage. The good thing is this video, all of these tips that I share with you, it actually will work for both mom and dad or any entrepreneur at all. So with that being said, guys, this is Candace from createfreedomwithcandace.com. If you like this video, be sure to give me a thumbs up, share this video, and subscribe to my channel. I'll be sharing more of this type of tips and tricks on how you can grow your business so you can actually gain the freedom that you deserve.